what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Pat Taste Performance. Today we have a beautiful Toro Power Max 826 LE. 8 horsepower, 26 inch clearing pad. Okay, has electric start. Toro has the patent on the shoe clogging technology. This is Tecumseh Power. This machine's in beautiful shape. I've worked on this machine before, actually 3 times, and it's back again. So the first time she clogged up the impeller with a newspaper, I had to get that out. Another time she left the gas in it, and I had to repair the electric start because it wasn't working. Now we are back again. She left the gas in it for the snowstorm, and guess what? It won't run off of choke. So she just wants a brand new carburetor. She does not want me to clean it. She does not want me to service it. So just like Burger King, have it your way. The customer wants, within reason, it gets. They want a new carburetor, let's put on a new carburetor. So let's confirm. And then we're also gonna, this has a fuel shutoff valve, so I shut off the fuel so the machine will run itself out of gas too. This thing is set. So it's out of gas. Alright, so let's get this thing off. Let me get my tool. Actually, this one's being used for another machine. So let's get this out. These are full sheet metal screws. Sorry, guys. Yes, I like to put everything contained and controlled in a cup. Alright, so we are going to disconnect the choke lever. Let me put you guys down. So we're going to disconnect the choke lever, like so. Just pull it out. Be careful, the exhaust is a little hot. Okay, so it's going to be a 5/16 to take this out. So see what you guys are looking at. Right here. Okay, and like I said, I've worked on this machine before, so usually these are Phillips heads. When the Phillips heads come out, I replace them actually with regular screws. So it's nice and easy, and they don't strip out. And these are 5/16 as well. Okay, now underneath, we are going to look for this green wire off the key. We're going to pull that off, like so. See? All right, and then we also have the oil dipstick tube. If you guys can see this Phillips head, that comes out as well. Take your Phillips head. Turn the chute so I have access, like so. It's my gear wrench ratcheting screwdriver with a T-handle at the end. You see how the engine cover just came right off? Let's put that in there. Pull it forward. Okay, and here we have our carburetor. Alright, so just a quick thing, carburetor, manifold, you see these two screws here by this metal plate, this is where the crankcase tube is, that's where you can check out your valves and check your adjustment. But this machine is way too new, so I'm not saying way too new, but you can see this machine is in great shape, it hasn't been used a lot, so we're not going to go crazy. Plus I know this machine runs, so we're going to pull off this small little line, one right here, pull it out. Okay, I have our new carburetor. Oh, it's actually my landing. New carburetor. And we can just transfer the parts right over. We're gonna get some AMECs too as well. Where can my AMECs be? The loan took her away from me. Oh, this weekend's been crazy. Where did I put you? Usually I put everything in the corner. There it is, right on top of my dirty rig. There you are! So I like AMECs because when you put two different metals together, or just anything in general, this stops the rust. Anti-seize. Made from the gods. So literally, we are just going to take parts off and put them on the new one. See? It's gonna line right up. So we're going to start with the small screws that hold the engine cover on. And this is the reason why I have my gear inch screwdriver, because they're a quarter inch. So I pop out this bit, like so. And guess what? We're taking these off. See that? No need for an extra tool. Work smarter, not harder. Okay. I'm gonna turn my Talente Gelato cover off. Just pay attention to make sure where you put it on. It comes off. Alright, we're going to get our anti-seize out. Now be careful, this stuff is not dangerous, but it's very sticky and spreads. So just take a little bit, you just want to put a little bit. Don't want to coat the whole screw, because as you thread it in, it will take care. As you thread it in, it will take care of the rest. It will spread down the threads of the screw as we tighten it. Alrighty. Let me do the same thing here. Okay, you guys see that? Remember, I started them by hand. So then we're going to take our screwdriver and just tighten these down. Remember, these are two different metals. You've got solid, like a solid steel, and then you have aluminum. So you don't want to strip out the aluminum. Just make them snug, tight, and a quarter turn. Maybe even less than a quarter turn. It's just to hold the engine cover. It's not something crazy. Okay. So now, we have carburetor here. This is a Phillips head, and I think this should be 7/16 or an 11 millimeter. We have the same on the other side. And then while we're here, you're going to pay attention to where the linkage hooks up. So I don't know if you guys can see, you have 1, 2, 3. It's in the second hole right here. So on the carburetor, right, you see this hole right here at the top of the triangle? That's the hole the linkage goes into. Alrighty, and then we have this here. Let me see if I remember correctly, if we can access these without taking them off. Yeah, perfect. So right now we're going to remove the choke linkage. And we're going to go left. So usually these strip out, but because I did this already, they're not going to strip out. If they do, no big deal. Get a pair of vice grips. And you're just going to have to work them out by hand. You're actually going to have to take the carburetor completely off. And then you can just, it's slow and painful, but you go right down. Slow and painful, but you just go nice and easy, take your time. Nice set of vice grips, nice and tight, and sometimes you have to do quarter turns. You don't want to damage the choke assembly. Okay. Remember, so we have two like metals, again. Get some anti-seize. Just a little bit. Listen, if you don't want to do anti-seize, don't. That's up to you, but I do. Makes it easier for me the next time, or you, or the next person who repairs it. It's like a little mechanic code, per se. I'm gonna slide that choke lever in. Make sure we're lined up. I'm gonna take our second screw around the anti-seize, see that? Just at the end. And we will start it by hand. Remember, please start your screws by hand. Do not any impact. Do not put an impact on these two. Just do everything by hand, please. Or else you're asking for trouble. Like that. So this is an aftermarket Chinese carburetor. If any of you guys have known to come someone out of business. Oh no. This just stripped out. To come someone out of business back in, what was it, 2008? And then, so, getting OEM parts is going to be very difficult. So that's it. So now because they're stripped, you can't use these. And I like to do everything in pairs. So I think these parts should be the same that I used for the choke housing. So we are going to use these for here. Here, and then I will get another pair for the housing itself. Oops, I'm glad that happened. Ran out of luck. Now because I have a bolt, I can use my gun. See that? I don't have to do it by hand. You see how easy that is? Didn't have to use a screwdriver, and that would have taken forever. It's a little loose. So let's make sure. Nice and tight. Alright, now we have to get the fuel line off. So you can just use your fingers, it's like a three-part clamp over here. Just get your fingers and you can just slide that off. No special tools needed. And then I'm going to take my fuel hose pliers, see how they have a screw, and then I'm just going to gently push off. I'm going to twist. Right, make sure it's broken away, and then just gently work it away. You see how there is no fuel that came out? Alright, now we're going to work on getting the carburetor out. So the two Phillip heads. See this here? It spins on its own because it's against the carburetor. So once you break it loose, so now on the other side, of the manifold, we have another same exact setup. And just as with the other hand, support it. Carburetor is free. Alrighty. Keep that there. It's the old carburetor. No good. I'm going to use this opportunity to anti-seize that. I'm going to anti-seize the other one. As you guys can tell, I love anti-seize. Stick that through. Gasket's in great shape, so I'm not going to even bother scraping it off, because this comes with a gasket. And we are going to give this a run. So remember, top of the triangle is where the linkage goes. Put that in first. Be careful not to bend it. And then, new one right there. Alright, so now we're tightening it. Remember, we started it by hand. Now remember, this is the hardest one, so I always like to do the hardest bolt first when that applies. Because I like to get the cursing and screaming and kicking and yelling out of the way. And then when I get to the easy one, when you're almost home, you can taste it. It's smooth sound. So I'm just flick this to tighten. So remember, don't want to make it grill tight, get it snug, and then just a quarter turn. That's it. That's it. The gasket will take care of the rest. You do not want to crush it, you do not want to strip, you do not want to break anything. So we're just going to put my thumb. There's no need to put a wrench there. And just hold it so it doesn't spin. And we are going to tighten it. Right, that's it. Snug. I'm going to put our fuel line back in. Remember, three prong, you could use your fingers. Actually, I use my fingers to take it off, but putting it back on, I'm going to use my 90 degree, these are made by Blue Point, but any brand will do, clamps. I'm gonna get a good grip in there, and we will slide it over, nice and grippy. We'll hook up our primer line, and then we're gonna release the fuel to verify that everything works. I don't know if you guys noticed that the original carb had an adjustable jet, and this one that I had in stock doesn't, and it shouldn't affect it. Turn the fuel line back on. We're gonna prime it. Let's see. I can hear it. And there's the fuel coming out. Perfect. Alright. Alright, my GoPro died and I'm not sure when. But as you guys can see, carburetor that came off was a fixture. See this one on the bottom here? This is how you can adjust and fine-tune your carburetor. The one that I had in stock is a fixed jet, also there's no tuning, so I was just making other adjustments between the idle screw and the RPM over here till I got the perfect balance. Obviously you want to do it on a hot engine, which I failed to do. I'm a little bit of a rush today, which is never a good thing to do. I'm trying to get one, two, three machines to our cup cadet. If you guys seen the other video, the cup cadet's going to get delivered today. The Craftsman is going to get delivered today, and this too. So I think I'm going to put all three machines in Mandingo, bing, bang, boom, pay me, have a nice day. So, now we can start putting, all right, so obviously this isn't going to work. So let's take this apart. I know she said she wanted a new carburetor. Is this after market? This looks after market. It's missing the Tecumseh stuff. Okay, so this is aftermarket. This should be 13. It's 12. I'm gonna turn on my compressor. We're gonna clean this carburetor. She says that's what she wants. This is going to turn into a carburetor cleaning. Okay, 12 millimeter. I'm going to take out this jet. I can see the gunk in here already. Wait till you pull off this bowl. Oh, look at that. Look at that. See that junk in there? So we are going to be replacing carburetor again. So we'll clean this all out. See that junk? No mas, no bien, no bien. So actually the bowl is starting to rust away. Well, let's get our jet nut. Just be careful of this gasket here. I don't know if you guys can see here. Let's focus. You see this opening here? We're gonna spritz down there. And then there's another one at the top here. Pick it up by eye. Take your carb clean, right through the solid. Right through the side as well. See how it comes out the side? And right down the hole. Okay. Then we're going to go right down the middle of the jet. Perfect. And then we got to clean out the other schmutz in there. Wait, do we have air pressure? pull out. That's a short little screwdriver. Press there. We'll roll this out. Alright, now we blow in, we blow out. That's your primer line. All these little lines inside here. Try and get in between. Now, when you guys clean a carburetor, never blow through here because there's a seat for the needle. So you always want to blow from the inside. Here we go from there. Alright, now we gotta do this all over again. So I am going to edit this video and we will put a new one on. Alright, so put the needle in. Oh, wait, what did I do? I think I lost you guys. Alright. So I'm gonna re-put the carburetor back together. You guys can see right here, this little clamp goes here, this opening. Slides in like so. And then I am going to put it back in the hole. So the way you took it out is the way it goes back. How about that? Yeah, it sits, and we're gonna get our pin. We're gonna slide it through. Turn the gasket. Alright, make sure. Okay, then we are going to put our bowl back in. So the way the bowl goes back in. Is that you see where this gap here, and then there's that the one that lowers that's lower, the gap goes with the carburetor, so that's where it allows the float to travel up and down. That is the carburetor jet. A jet. Stick that back in the bowl. I am not going to use my ratchet. I am going to use it as a ratchet. I'm not going to hit it. You know, I'm not going to apply the trigger. Because I'm too lazy to go get my. That's that. Alright, now I have to put the carburetor back on. I have to reverse this whole process. Because you know, I'm going to record this. I didn't mean to cut you guys in and out because I screwed up. But I guess I'll just fast forward all this. You know, we all learn from our mistakes. You guys can definitely learn from mine. Because I know if you have the adjustable jet, a lot of the guys, they prefer the adjustable jet so you could do more fine tuning. They actually try and you can go from adjustable jet, I mean a fixed jet, to an adjustable jet without a problem. Come on. How can I get you in there? Both of these, please don't tell me I'm missing both of these. What is this? Is this 516? This is. bolt in here. And because aluminum is softer, we're actually threading it in at the same time. It will not be a problem taking out. This is actually better because it's almost impossible to round off the bolt. Working it in and out, so you're just making threads as you board. See here, that goes back in there, no problem. A little effort. Thank you. was playing with the idle jet, remember? The idle jet right here. This screw right here. You turn this in and out to mess with the fuel mixture. So what you want to do is you want to buy it. Usually I think if you turn all the way in, and it's 2.5 turns out, that's a good starting point. And then you fine tune it. You tighten it, you keep loosening it until you hear it to bog down. And then you turn it once it goes back to perfect, and that's it, you're dialed in. Of course you want to do this on a warm engine. So now we are going to put this back together. Please like and subscribe, even better if you want to share it for a couple of good laughs. Comments, good and bad, I know I messed up. So in the meantime, I will put the correct, in case you guys need to replace this carburetor, I will put the correct carburetor number in the description to this video. Got some editing to do, but this is what happens when you learn from our mistakes, and luckily we were able to salvage this carburetor. Even though she wants us to replace it, hopefully, you know, she'll be happy that it saved her a couple of bucks. I mean, like I said, I've done a couple of workless things a few times, you know, because she's a very good customer. I'm just going to charge her the pickup and delivery, and no big deal. All right? I'll see you guys on the next episode.